Here we're going to have a look at creating a target camera. Now, first of all, we need something to view, so we'll create a quick plane and some primitive objects to view through. So there's our plane. We'll use auto grid to place our objects on this plane, and we'll create a box. And just remember base to pivots and a cylinder. And then we've got three objects that we can now view through using our camera. Now, on the Create tab, move along four buttons and you'll see a small camera button. Click on this one and you can see you have target and free. First thing first, we'll have a look at the target camera. So click on that button and in the top viewport, we shall create our camera. So we're going to create this looking from the bottom right hand corner of the top viewport, and we'll release the button in between the three primitive objects. So click in and drag in. When we release the button, you can see the camera is now pointing at a small box, and if we zoom right in, you can see that we've got a very small box, quite hard to see. You probably see it easier on your screens. You can see this small blue box here. Now that small dummy object allows you to move where the camera is pointing to. So if we select that, you can see we can move exactly where the camera is pointing to using the select to move, just like you do with all the primitive objects. Now we want to see what this camera is actually looking at, so we're going to convert the perspective viewport into a camera viewport. So right click on the perspective name, and in views you'll see at the top we have camera 1, so we click on that, and there we are, we can see exactly what the camera is looking at. Now we can move the camera around and the viewport reflects where the camera is looking. This is one way of moving the camera around, and in the left viewport we'll raise this up a little bit and just spin it round again so you can see what I mean. Now there's another way, and this is an interactive way, and if we maximise the camera viewport you'll see what I mean. So there's our maximised camera viewports. In the bottom right hand corner you can see a number of different buttons. We're going to have a look at the dolly camera button and the orbit camera button. Now the dolly camera allows you to zoom in and out, and there's our zoom in and out there, so we can move the camera in and out. And the orbit camera allows you to rotate around your dummy object, and it's as easy as that. Now the bonus about using the camera object is when you have a perspective viewport, if you rotate the view, it's very hard to get it back to the exact view that you was looking at. So if we wanted to render our shapes here, as you can see, if I then rotated the perspective viewport and I wanted to render exactly the same view, it's quite tricky finding roughly the same spots. So you can see there's just a slight change. Now when you use a camera, every time you render it, it's always there. So if we switch from camera to perspective, rotate so that we can see what's going on in our scene, and then switch back to the camera view, exactly the same shot is taken. So you can see that the camera object is essential for viewing your scene. Although you're used to using the standard four ports configuration with the top, front, left and perspective, when you do create your final scenes, it's a good idea to use a camera object, and then you can always get exactly the same view that you've required to.